सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई एंड नाबार्ड। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन, एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द डेली सेशंस, एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन फॉलो दिस इंस्टाग्राम profile where you will find all merge ki dawa. So let's begin with the very first question. How much amount of development assistance loan has been committed by the government of Japan to support India's efforts to combat COVID-19? So guys, Japan ne kuch development assistance loan diya hai to the government of India, where government can provide support to those who are affected by the COVID-19. Okay, and this loan amount is how much? Japanese yen 30 billion. All right, option A, Japanese yen 30 billion. Here is the correct answer. So Japan government has given this loan for the development assistance to those who are affected by the COVID-19. Basically, ye jo loan hoga, it will support India's effort to combat COVID-19. Okay, and the correct answer here is what? JPY 30 billion, Japanese yen 30 billion. And here in this news, you just have to remember one or two things. First of all, you have to remember this amount, that's 30 billion Japanese yen, and then you have to remember the purpose of the loan. Okay, and what is the purpose? It has the purpose to help India in its fight against COVID-19. All right, and talking about Japan, so recently guys, we have partnered with Japan in the specified skilled worker. We also have discussed about this specified skilled worker sector. Mein we have partnered with Japan and Yoshihide Suga. Yoshihide Suga is the Prime Minister, and इस साल 2021 में Olympics होगा टोक्यो में. Okay, it is Summer Olympics, जो कि 2020 में होने वाला था. That is going to be conducted this year in the capital of Japan, that is Tokyo. And what about 2024 Olympics that are going to be held in Paris, and 2028 it's Los Angeles. And what about the Winter Olympics? What about the Winter Olympics in 2022? Winter Olympics, Beijing, while in 2026, they are going to be conducted in Milan Cortina, which is a city of Italy. Okay, so here the correct answer is what? Option A, Japanese yen 30 billion. And now let's move on to question number 2. With which organization has IREDA signed an MOU for providing its technical expertise in developing renewable energy projects? So IREDA ने एक MOU साइन किया है ताकि वो अपनी एक्सपर्टीज प्रोवाइड करा सके टू दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन डेवलपिंग द रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी प्रोजेक्ट्स. सो यू हैव टू नेम दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ओके, सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस न्यूज फर्स्ट. सो द न्यूज इज व्हाट? दिस MOU हैज बीन साइन बिटवीन IREDA, इंडियन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी डेवलपमेंट एजेंसी लिमिटेड एंड NHPC लिमिटेड. ओके, किसके साथ MOU है? NHPC लिमिटेड के साथ. एंड व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ दिस MOU? सो बेसिकली IREDA विल प्रोवाइड इट्स एक्सपर्टीज to NHPC in its renewable energy and conservation projects. So that is the basic objective of this MOU, and you have to remember what is the target of India in the renewable energy. That's 175 gigawatt by the year 2022, while it's 450 gigawatts by the year 2030. And talking about IREDA, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency Limited, so it was guys established in 1987. It is a mini ratna category 1 under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, which is currently headed by Mr. R.K. Singh. And you should also remember that it has the objective of providing financial support. Okay, providing financial support to the renewable energy projects in our country. And Mr. Pradeep Kumar Das is the current chairperson, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. All right, so these are some basic information about IREDA, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency Limited. And this MOU has been signed with NHPC Limited. All right. So therefore, the correct answer should be option A, NHPC Limited. And now let's move on to question number 3. Consider the following statement regarding NCAVES India Forum 2020, and you have to identify the correct statement. So it is a virtual conference. You can say it is a virtual forum 2021. That was organized by Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, which in short is MOSPI. So let's discuss about this. So this is natural capital accounting and valuation of ecosystem services. Natural capital accounting and valuation of ecosystem services is the full form of this NCAVES. And India Forum 2020 has been organized by Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation in association with Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Okay, in association with Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And now, what is this natural capital accounting? So guys, natural capital here denotes the stock of renewable and non-renewable energy sources. Okay, what is the meaning of natural capital here? The stock of renewable and non-renewable energy sources. And what is the meaning of natural capital accounting? So in the natural capital accounting, we are measuring the flows of renewable and non-renewable energy sources. Basically, hum kya kar rahe hain isme? जो हमारा रिन्यूएबल और नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज है उसके फ्लो का हिसाब किताब रख रहे हैं इन द नेचुरल कैपिटल अकाउंटिंग. एंड व्हाट आर द इकोसिस्टम सर्विसेज? सो देयर आर वेरियस सर्विसेज दैट वी अवेल फ्रॉम द इकोसिस्टम, दैट वी अवेल फ्रॉम द बायोटिक एंड एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द इकोसिस्टम, लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल फूड, वाटर, हैबिटेट एटसेट्रा. ओके, सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ नेचुरल कैपिटल अकाउंटिंग एंड इकोसिस्टम सर्विसेज. एंड दिस फोरम 2021 has been organized by MOSPI, Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, with an aim to advance the theory and practice of ecosystem accounting in India. हमारे देश में जो ecosystem accounting है उसको advance करने के लिए, उसको और ज्यादा अच्छा बनाने के लिए this India Forum has been organized. Okay, and what is this project? This is basically guys a project, natural capital accounting and valuation of ecosystem services. Basically, it is a project which is being funded by the European Union and it is jointly implemented by United Nations Statistical Division, United Nations Environment Program and Secretariat of Convention on Biodiversity. So these three are supporting the implementation of this project, while this is being funded by European Union. And there are five countries which are taking part in this project, which are India, Brazil, China, South Africa and Mexico. Okay, and talking more about this, so in India, as I told you, this project is being implemented by MOSPI in association with Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change and National Remote Sensing Center, which works under the Department of Space in our country. And after the participation in this project, it has helped MOSPI to come out with its environmental statistics under the title which is known as NVStats India. जो हमारे एनवायरमेंट का अकाउंट है वो पूरा का पूरा इसमें दिया जाता है. इट इज अ पब्लिकेशन ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इंप्लीमेंटेशन विच इज नोन एज एनवी स्टैट्स इंडिया. ओके, एंड दिस इज अबाउट द नेचुरल कैपिटल अकाउंटिंग. सो गाइज, एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट इज अ टर्म यूज्ड फॉर स्टॉक ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एंड नॉन रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज. एंड नेचुरल कैपिटल अकाउंटिंग मीन्स कीपिंग रिकॉर्ड्स एंड टू मेजर द स्टॉक एंड फ्लोज ऑफ द एनर्जी सोर्सेज. And for natural capital accounting, what is the framework followed? इसके जब हम measure करते हैं, इसका जब हिसाब रखते हैं, then what are the steps that we follow, which are System of Environmental Economic Accounting (SEEA). This provides a framework for this natural capital accounting, guys. And there was a framework, and UNSEEA. There is a framework which is known as UNSEEA, United Nations System of Environmental Economic Accounting. It is taken, which provides a framework for the natural capital accounting, and it was signed, it was adopted in the year 2012, and it has the direct focus on the relationship between the environment and the economy. Okay, so this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. Question number 3 is what? So you have to identify the correct statement regarding this NCAVES India. So this forum has been organized by MOFCC. No guys, the principal organization, the principal ministry to organize this is Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Now, can you tell me who is the Minister of Statistics and Program Implementation? Write down in the comments. So this statement, guys, is incorrect. This project is funded by the World Bank. So is it World Bank? No, that's European Union. So therefore, this statement is also incorrect. And Mexico is one of the countries taking part in this project. Yes, there are five countries: Brazil, India, China, South Africa, and Mexico. So which means this statement is absolutely correct, and we have to identify the correct statement. Option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. With which bank? NAB Foundation, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of NABARD. It is a Section 8 company. And Section 8, basically it is a non-profit company, and it is a wholly owned subsidiary of NABARD. And There are six subsidiaries of NABARD, guys. There are six subsidiaries of NABARD. One is NAB Foundation, and the name of other five subsidiaries you have to tell me in the comment. Write down in the comments the name of other five subsidiaries of NABARD. One is NAB Foundation, and you have to tell me the name of other five. Okay. So this NAB Foundation has signed an MOU to provide working capital to SHGs for undertaking My Pad, My Right campaign. Okay, so ये campaign है. That was launched by Union Minister of Women and Child Development Smriti Zubin Irani, and it is being implemented by NABARD, basically by NAB Foundation. So for undertaking this project, NAB Foundation has signed an MOU with a bank to provide working capital to SHG self-help group. So you have to tell the name of the bank. So let's discuss this news. So guys, the name of the bank, here we can see the logo, it's Central Bank of India. And as you know, Central Bank of India was established in the year 1911, and it is the first bank that was wholly owned by the Indians. It is basically the first Indian commercial bank, and it was founded by Sir Sorabji. It was founded by Sir Sorabji and Mr. Firoz Shah Mehta. Firoz Shah Mehta was the first chairperson of this bank, and it is headquartered in Mumbai. It is headquartered in Mumbai, and you have to tell me the current MD and CEO of this Central Bank of India. And headquarter it is in Mumbai. All right, so moving ahead, if you talk about the project My Pad My Right, so it was launched by Union Minister of Women and Child Development Smriti Irani on 15th October this year only, which was the International Day of Rural Women. Okay, this 15th October was the International Day of Rural Women. On that day this project was launched, and it is basically a menstrual hygiene and livelihood program under which sanitary napkin machines will be provided to the self-help groups, and in one district one SHG will be identified that will be provided rupees 5 lakh. Okay, usko kitne rupaye diye jayenge? 5 lakh rupaye diye jayenge, which covers the cost of machine, training, rent, etc. And this project, guys, is undertaken by NAB Foundation, as I told you, which is a subsidiary of NABARD, and it will also get funding from Microcredit Innovations Department, which is under NABARD, and NABARD will provide in upcoming 3 years a total 50 crores for this project My Pad My Right campaign. All right, and it will be implemented, guys, in all the districts of our country. Jitne bhi districts hain hamare desh mein, sare districts mein this project will be implemented in the upcoming 3 years. All right, so we have to tell the name of the bank. So option C, Central Bank of India, is the correct answer, and I hope you can easily answer this question now. Central Bank of India. Okay, so guys, that's it for the session. So these are the 4 questions for the day. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.